I mean, I'm just a regular guy. So when we talk about AI, we need to break it down into something that is easy to digest. When you show it a banana and you show, you know, different samples of a banana, then it knows it's a banana. You can teach it that. If you paint one of the bananas red and you show it that, then all of a sudden it doesn't know that that's a banana. And that's because, you know, it doesn't know that a banana can also be red.
Seeing football players having a lot of fun is just a mission and a product I'm really passionate about myself. I've played a good bit of football myself, didn't get as far ultimately as I had hoped. And even now, playing with Veo 1 or 2 days a week, it's a brilliant thing to just be able to record your matches, capturing the highlights and sharing them afterwards on Slack. Right. It all starts out with us thinking about what data we will need. Annotation is getting data labeled so that models have something to learn from. It's really important to be disciplined with your data. Otherwise, you risk to let the models overfit, which means getting very, very good at the recordings they have looked at and finding patterns that are so specific that they won't be there in other recordings.
If a ball is something that is white, then anything that is white, you know, would be recognized as a ball. So you really need to have a lot of examples of what a ball looks like. Not even just that, you also need a lot of examples of the field itself. And those could look very different.
We received some recordings from a completely blue pitch. It was very, very blue. And our models were confused by this.
We had weird cases like that and, you know, bald-headed guy or something like that. That's white, so that's gotta be a ball.
I think it's surprising to some how much effort we're putting into the last 10 or 5 or even 2% sometimes. This is really where we need to scratch our heads multiple times and come up with good ideas. Users get out in the field, raise their Veo cameras on tripods, start recording. It eventually gets uploaded to the cloud. That's when our AI pipelines get triggered. When I say pipeline, that's typically multiple models working in sequence, coming with predictions. Follow cam is the broadcast experience that you get where a virtual camera follows the action, just the way a manual camera operator would do it. So directing the camera and zooming. Event detection is finding the timestamps in the recording where certain events occur. In football, such as corner kicks and goal kicks, free kicks, goals, of course, is probably the most relevant one to many. The ball tracking is maybe conceptually simpler to explain because it's training a model to keep track of where the ball is. Just as you and I would be able to point at the ball, that's what we're asking a model to do. And then letting the models figure out the patterns and signals in it for itself. That's how we train a machine learning model. So one cool thing with Veo Go to me was that it didn't require more.
We had the cameras, we had the lenses, we had all of that information.
We had quite robust models that the Go team could, you know, pick off the shelf and start using.
We just had to figure out iPhones and recording parts.